As a sad, sad single person, your food choices are limited. You can eat sad, sad frozen dinners or order takeout for one.
Yeah, I did order last night and the night before. I know that you're concerned about me.
Or you can just give up. Or you can cook for yourself?
Yeah, you can cook food that tastes good for just one person.
If you follow complex recipes that take hours to prepare.
No, it doesn't have to take very long.
And hundreds of dollars at the grocery store.
Yes, that's just what groceries cost, but no, you can spend hundreds on the whole month.
Impossible!
It's not. You can cook for yourself on a reasonable budget and not spend all day in the kitchen. When you're single and you live by yourself, cooking for yourself can seem like an asinine chore, but learning to cook better is totally worth it. It can save you money, improve your health, and it's better for the environment. It's actually easier than trying to explain to the fifth Uber Eats driver in a row how to get into your apartment complex. I'm not hating on takeout. Sometimes it's lovely to have someone bring you food. Sometimes it's fun. Sometimes it tastes better. But takeout isn't cheap. Groceries are just cheaper. They just are. There's a reason takeaway food is so good. It's got more fat and sugar than you probably would use if you were cooking it yourself. Fat and sugar are delicious. They make things taste amazing, but it's not a good health practice for anyone to not pay attention to the macros and what they're eating. And the environmental toll that your takeout habit has on the planet? Is your garbage can overflowing with containers? But I recycle them, you say. You wish. Most municipalities don't recycle styrofoam. And what about plastic? Technically recyclable, but in the US, we just don't recycle it. But what about compostable plastics, you say? They can be composted, but only in a commercial composting facility. And there are not many facilities that do that. So, yeah, just cook at home more often, even if you're only cooking for one. Here's how to do it. First, think simple. Not everything you eat has to be a restaurant-worthy recipe. A piece of salmon and some green beans, that's a meal. Some store-bought rotisserie chicken and some rice, maybe add a green thing in there, that's a meal. Be honest with yourself. You may want to make something, but you also may not have the skills to do it. And you might want to eat more healthy foods. So you buy some broccoli because it's healthy, but you actually fucking hate broccoli. You don't have to force yourself to eat things you don't want to eat. In fact, forcing yourself to cook things you hate will make you want to cook less. Watch some YouTube videos. It worked for me. But seriously, there's some great channels that teach you how to be a better cook and to like cooking. Shop wisely. You don't have to go to the store every day. Actually, I advise against it. And if you shop well, you won't have to go to the store every day. Buy versatile foods that you can use in many ways. A good example of this is that rotisserie chicken. Eat it hot the first day, put it on a salad the next day, put it in some chili on day three. Stock your pantry and freezer. I feel like everyone says this, but it's true. Having spices and seasonings, oils, other pantry staples makes it easier to whip up a little something something. Get creative. One of my favorite things to do is host my own Chopped episode. I take it as a challenge to look around the kitchen, see what I have, and think about what I can make. I've made some tasty shit cooking like that. Here's a caveat. If you're new to cooking, this is gonna be a little bit more difficult for you. I'm not gonna lie about that. But if you have an understanding of what flavors go together, you can make some surprisingly good food. Eat leftovers. Cook once, eat twice, especially as a single person. Most recipes feed four people. It's just smart time management to cook once and eat twice. And I'm sorry if you fucking hate leftovers. You need to face reality and that you can eat the same thing 2 days in a row. I'm not suggesting you make a giant pot of chili and eat it for 3 weeks straight. It's one meal of leftovers. Also, here's where experience comes into play again. It's really helpful to know what makes good leftovers. Entertain yourself. Listen to podcasts while you're cooking. May I suggest the Spinster Life podcast? Or watch TV? Or talk to a friend? If you don't like cooking because you think it takes too long and you get bored, just find something else to occupy yourself with. Learn stuff, improve your kitchen skills, and then you'll spend less time in the kitchen. Watch videos, take a class. You'll just be able to do things faster, like chopping vegetables. You know, maybe just take a knife skills class regardless, even if your objection to cooking is not time-based, because no one wants to drive themselves to the emergency room with their finger in a bag of ice. Learn 20 recipes. You don't need to be a walking cookbook. Most big families can eat a varied enough menu with only 20 recipes. You're only one person. Between leftovers and dining out and, yeah, sure, your occasional takeout, 20 recipes might last you 2 months. And, oh yeah, remember how I said get creative? Once you know a recipe, play with it. Unless you're baking, recipes are a suggestion, not the rules. Learn how to substitute. I think of recipes like a Pinterest board. It's just there for some inspiration. Some beginning cooks get frustrated when a recipe calls for something and they don't have it. Don't get frustrated, look around. More than likely you can sub out kale for spinach. You can add parsley instead of dill. This doesn't work universally, but in time, you'll figure it out. Take shortcuts. Just because you're a home cook now doesn't mean you have to make everything from scratch. Pasta sauce in a jar, pre-cooked chicken, pre-marinated meats, pre-chopped onions, whatever makes it easier for you to start cooking, just do it. And I'm not gonna just send you out into the cold, harsh world to fend for yourself. I'm gonna show you a recipe. It's one of my old favorites, and I actually haven't made this in a while, but it's easy, it's nutrient dense, and it tastes pretty fucking good. Whitefish en papillote. Here's all you need to make this fancy dish.
A baking sheet. Parchment paper. Aluminum foil, optional. A white fish, I used cod. Zucchini. Lemon. Fresh herbs, optional. Salt, pepper, and seasonings of your choice. Cooking oil or butter. And olives for garnish, optional.
Preheat your oven to 375 to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Put some parchment paper on a baking sheet, the vegetables around. Put the fish in the center. Oil and season, whack some lemon slices on top. Origami your parchment paper into an envelope. And if you can't fold to save your life, don't worry about it. That's where the tinfoil comes in. Use some tinfoil to wrap up your little fish packet. Bake for around 12 minutes. The most important part is that it gets done. When whitefish is done, it will flake up really nicely. Then just unwrap your package. Garnish with the garnish of your choice. I chose Kalamata olives and parsley. Serve over brown rice or white rice or polenta or quinoa or more vegetables or a side salad, or just allow the fish to be the star. Completely up to you. Ooh, in awe and delight, take a few pictures for the gram and chow down. This is good. It took me about 10 minutes to throw it together, and all the ingredients probably cost me about $4. Living alone doesn't mean that you can't make amazing food and enjoy your own cooking talent. Well, that's all for me. I'll see you next time. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.